Well, hello there, Big Red Machine. Welcome to Between Two Drums with Jody, Sean, and Kim. Welcome to the school year 2020-21, and yes, it has been quite a year so far, and we are committed, just know this, that we are committed to making this the best year ever, despite all of the differences that we're going to go through, and the key is doing it together. We're going to have a great time, and we thought that we would just come to you by this video to kind of give you some idea of what you can expect here in the band during our school day during this year. So we're going to start by introducing our band directors to you.
My name is Sean Dyke. I'm entering my eighth year of teaching, my fourth year here at Crestview. I am a trombone player, the best instrument in the band. And I graduated high school at Tate over in Canton.
Where'd you go to college, Mr. Dyke?
I went to college at the best university in the country, University of Southern Mississippi.
Southern Miss to the top.
To the top.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Dyke.
I'm Kim Whaley. This will be my first year at Crestview High School, 27th year teaching. I've been with middle school, and I'm ready to get up here to the big level with the high schoolers. I'm from Pensacola, Florida. I play the clarinet, which is the best instrument. Some of those guys. Went to LSU, go Tigers. And I'm looking forward to a great year.
Thank you, Ms. Whaley. I'm Mr. Dunn. I'm the director of bands here at Crestview High School, and this is my 30th year as a teacher. Yeah, I don't want to hear it. Hashtag old. This is my 26th year on campus as a faculty member at Crestview High School. I was the assistant director here for 10 years, and then the rest of the time I've been the head director. I think this is my 16th year as head director, something like that. I'm old, numbers escape me. I am, of course, as Mr. Dyke is, a trombone player, the greatest instrument ever created. Thank you very much. I also went to the greatest university in the country, University of Southern Mississippi, Southern Miss to the top. I am a graduate of Crestview High School. I graduated in 1986, and I'm very proud to be a Bulldog. I'm very proud that this is my band, just like it's your band. And I've always asked every year, this is your band, what are you going to do with it? And I'm looking forward to what we are going to do together with the Big Red Machine. Ms. Whaley, while we're introducing people, you want to introduce our intern? He can come swing in here and say hi.
Well, we're absolutely delighted to have Mr. Gio Pereira from FSU. He's a horn player coming to join us. He'll be with us all the way the first semester.
All right. Welcome, Gio. Mr. Pereira.
Mr. Pereira.
Yes, thank you very much. We're excited. What a great team that we have here with the Big Red Machine, and it's so exciting that we're finally getting back to seeing you, and we want to just go over a few things with you. It's not going to get long and drawn out and a bunch of dry rule stuff. But we are going to go over a few things relative to our daily routine here in the band room. So we're going to start with Mr. Dyke. He's going to tell you the schedule that his classes will follow this year.
So for first period, we'll be doing percussion, the percussion class. Second period, I'll have the flags and color guard. Third period, I'll have, is that a duty for me?
It is. You'll be here in the room with concert band.
Yes.
Fourth period, I'll have a symphonic band. Fifth period, I'll be in here duty, watching Mr. Dunn with the wind ensemble. Sixth period, I'll have jazz band. And seventh period, I'll have the new brass techniques class.
So let's take a pause right here and explain a little bit about your jazz band class. Who is eligible to be in the jazz ensemble too?
Anybody is eligible to be in the jazz band. You just have to be in a concert band to be in the jazz
or
band.
Or a color guard class.
Yeah, or a color guard class.
If you're a color guard member who plays an instrument, even if it's clarinet, we have room for everybody in the second jazz ensemble, clarinet players, flute players. It's a very easy switch over to saxophone. We have tenor saxophones, barry saxophones. So if that's something that you're interested in, see Mr. Dyke. And so now explain the new brass techniques class. What's that all about?
This brass techniques class is it's a unique class. We'll go into a little bit deeper into technique. You'll have a more one-on-one interaction between an instructor, whether it's myself or Miss Whaley. Also, we'll be going over things like solo and ensemble stuff, learning about daily routines, discussing topics like performance anxiety and things like that.
Auditions,
scholarship auditions for colleges, all county, all state.
So what about the people who might, brass players who might want to pick up a secondary instrument? Would that be a good place for them to?
Definitely. We have a few, even woodwind players, picking up secondary instruments.
If you wanted to do a brass, yeah, that'd be great. So anybody who wants to know more about playing brass instruments, whether you're a brass instrument already, or if you're interested in picking up a secondary brass instrument, or if you're a woodwind player who would like to learn brass, there's your class. And that would be seventh period, correct?
Seventh period, yes.
Great. Now on to Ms. Whaley. What is your class schedule like?
All right, so first period, I'll be assisting with the percussion class. Second period, I'll be in the band room doing the concert prep band. Third period, I'll be doing the concert band in the band room. Fourth period, I'll be helping with the symphonic band. Fifth period, helping with wind ensemble, whatever way they need. Sixth period is the chamber music class. And then seventh period, I'll be doing the woodwind techniques that Mr. Dyke was talking about as he does the brass techniques.
So let's talk for a minute about that chamber winds class. Quick background, we started this class a few years ago, and it is one of the best classes we offer, and it's very unique to our program. We're the only program that I know of, a high school program, that has a chamber winds class, and it's an exciting offering that we have. And so tell us a little bit about what the chamber winds class is all about.
Okay, so chamber winds and is just when you take a small group, it's a smaller group, so maybe a trio or a quartet or a quintet or maybe a brass choir. And personally, it's my favorite thing to play in, is chamber music. I love it. I didn't get exposed to it until I was in college, so that's how Mr. Dunn spoke. It's such a unique opportunity. But we are forming like quintet, woodwind quintets or brass quintets or saxophone quartets, horn quartets, yeah. All kind of, there's so many different combinations you can do. And then you are the only person playing your part. And that's what makes it so much fun and such a challenge. And it's just you can come together, get rehearsed each day, and then we're gonna do performances. It's gonna be a great class, a great way to grow too.
And we will have those ensembles playing at pre-concert, for example, out in the foyer. It will also be a great place to prepare for solo and ensemble.
Oh, yeah.
And a really good place to prepare for auditions and things as you work on solos and small groups. There are so many wonderful things that happen when you play in a small ensemble. It is the best way to get better on your instrument. And it's just a fantastic thing that we are now able to offer. So I will also be helping first period percussion. We will divide up with the battery and the pit between the band room and the auditorium. Second period, we will be in the auditorium in the multipurpose room I'll be doing the rifles, color guard. Third period, we'll all be in here as Ms. Whaley's working with the concert band. Fourth period, we'll all be in here as Mr. Dyke is working with the symphonic band. Fifth period, we'll all be in here as I'm working with the wind ensemble. What am I doing sixth period?
You're doing the brass chamber.
I'm doing chamber winds, that's right. I'm doing chamber winds. At the same time, again, same kind of thing. It'll be a meeting together at the same place, working on everything. And the seventh period is the Jazz Ensemble 1. Jazz Ensemble 1 is primarily for the advanced players who have either been in jazz band before or who did well on their auditions and are at the upper end of their sections. We play a lot of literature. I like to say we devour literature, and we sight read a lot. And if we can find a place to play, we will go out and play. And we work on being a working musician in that class. So it's a lot of fun, and it can get into some fairly complicated jazz literature, and it's always a lot of fun. So that'll be our day for all of us. And of course, we're on the block schedule this year, And if you're wondering how that will work, don't panic, because I have taught on block schedule. You have too, right? And it does work. It's just a little bit of a learning curve, longer periods, alternating odds and evens on the Mondays and Tuesdays, and the seventh period is a daily class, and then every other Friday rotates to the other odd or even schedule. You'll get used to it. Trust me. Don't panic. We will make it through, and I know for a fact that having taught on the block schedule here about 20 years ago, it works. I like it because we get longer rehearsals. So we'll make it work, and you'll have a great time doing it, and I think it can be a very beneficial learning model in all the classes. So that's the schedule for daily routine. We're going to talk a little bit about what it looks like when you come into the band room. So every day, we will have something either playing on the speaker system or showing on the video, and the lights will probably be about, you know, like they are now, kind of dim. So your job is to come in the band room and go immediately to your instrument slot, which we will make sure everyone has an area. That's something that we're going to work on when we start school. And we ask that when you come into the room, when you're moving around, that you wear your mask that we're going to give everybody. You can wear the one that we give you. You can wear the one that you like the best. But we ask when we give you these that you keep up with them, because they're going to be our uniform masks. We ask that when you come in the room that you wear your mask as you are coming through the room, going to get your instruments and your music and coming to your seat. The seats will be a little different this time, and we'll get used to that as well. When you get to your seat and you get everything ready, we ask that you keep watching what's ever going on the screen, listening to whatever's playing. We don't socialize, we don't talk, we don't hang around. We, as soon as we walk in the room, we are ready for band. We're all about band. This is not the time to stand around. If you have a need, an actual need, to use the restroom, we ask that you do that quickly and then get back. No one should be in the restroom by the time class begins. Please know that. And we'll give you some time to get used to that. Don't panic. It's going to be okay. Wear your mask as you're walking around, and when you get to your seat, keep your mask on. When it is time to play, we will pull our masks down and play. When it's time to stop playing, the mask will come back up. We're going to talk more about those kinds of procedures later. So just know that that's generally the policy. When you're playing, no mask. When you're not playing, mask. So if you get to play the tacit, some of you may be assigned the tacit. It might be on your part, or it might be just something that we ask you to play. If we ask you to play the tacit, then you're going to wear your mask while you play it. So, and we'll explain all that later. Again, don't panic.
Is that soprano, tacit, or alto?
We have soprano, alto, tenor, and bass tacit.
Wow.
Here in the high school. See, that's high school.
I did not realize.
See, that's high school. We've got it, the full family of tacits. So that's something to look forward to, too. So anyway, we're going to take a break. And when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit about the handbook and the calendar and some other very important things. So stay tuned for a word from our sponsors, and we'll be right back on Between Two Drums.
Next, we would like to talk about highlights of the band handbook. The band handbook can be found on charms in the handout and files section. Attendance. Attendance is important in everything that we do. It determines the ultimate success or failure of the group. Think about it. If you're not at a rehearsal, we must adjust for your absence, whether it's the balance of the band or the balance of the visual aspect and the choreography. If you're not at a game or performance, the band suffers. In the BRM, we only have two excuses for absences. One, personal illness, and two, death in the family. All other excuses are handled on a case-by-case basis. Below you will find a list of excuses submitted in the past. All were judged to be unexcused. If you have an issue getting a ride to or from the school, talk to your friends, talk to your section leaders. We have such a great support system here and tons of people willing to help. Okay, just let us know and we'll help you out. If you're going to be in the band, be in the band. Grading. The state of Florida Department of Education recognizes band and any other performing art class as a co-curricular class, meaning a portion of the class is held during the school day while the remaining of the class is held outside of the traditional school day. Listed below is an explanation of students' grading criteria for these performing arts classes. 20% daily grade, are you prepared and are you here and are you participating? 20% for the projects, playing tests and pass-offs, and other class-assigned projects. 20% goes to the rehearsals, are you at the rehearsals after school? And 40% goes to performances, such as MPAs, school concerts, football games, etc. The following is a breakdown of point deductions for each infraction. Unexcused absences from a rehearsal is 15 points off. Unexcused absences for a performance is 50 points off the performance grade. Tardy to rehearsal is 5 points off the rehearsal grade. Tardy to a performance is 10 points off the performance grade. If you're unprepared for a rehearsal, such as no equipment, instrument, or music, is 5 points off the rehearsal grade. And unprepared for class, that's 5 points off the daily grade. Our conduct. In case you haven't realized, we take band very seriously. We have a great deal of fun, but we always maintain the first class atmosphere in the Big Red Machine. When you accept membership in the BRM, you become a the instead of an A. The public watches and judges you as a member of the Big Red Machine, not just as a student at Crestview High School. Uniforms. We have a dress uniform, which is what the marching band wears, and a travel uniform underneath that dress uniform. The collection and distribution process for the dress uniform will be different this year so we can avoid large gatherings. Stay tuned for further details. For purposes of uniform inspection, the following requirements will be checked before each performance. Do you have white, clean white gloves? Do you have mid-calf length white socks? Are your band shoes polished with clean laces? The only jewelry you're allowed to have are small stud earrings, one in each earlobe. They must be clear. No facial piercings in the eyebrows, nose, lips, eyelids, cheeks, whatever. Those are not allowed. Gauges of any size are not allowed. Your hair color must remain natural. We appreciate the pink and blue hair colors as individuals, but when you put that uniform on, you need to have a natural hair color. So no visible tattoos are allowed. No earbuds or headphones or earpieces are allowed. Facial hair must be neatly trimmed, and instruments must be clean and in good playing condition. If you are found to be in violation of these requirements, you will be given the opportunity to fix the problem. If you are unable to fix this problem, you will be dismissed from the performance and will result in an unexcused absence for that performance. Travel uniform. Your travel uniform should have been purchased from the band merchandise website already. While wearing the uniform, the shorts must be worn at the waist, no sagging. The shirt must be tucked in at all times. You may wear white ankle socks with the travel uniform, but mid-calf length white socks must be worn with the dress uniform. White band shoes for band members and white kid-like shoes for the color guard will be worn with the travel uniform. The official Big Red Machine travel uniform does not consist of hats, scarves, sandals, or flip-flops, and untucked shirts. The Florida Department of Education requires a minimum grade point average of 2.0 for all participants of the marching band. Never let problems in a class build to the point of being a hindrance to your other responsibilities, such as playing in the band. Ask for help. We want to help you find academic success as well as musical success while a member of the Big Red Machine.
Here's something we wish we didn't have to talk about.
Band fees. Band fees are $200 per member, $180 per member if you have more than one child in band. The deadline of August 14th you see on the screen has been pushed back to October 31st to help out. Now, these band fees are some of the lowest fees that you'll see in Northwest Florida. Some area schools I've seen range from $500 to $600, and that's not including contest fees, things like that. Some additional expenses for various groups within the BRM. We have a school-owned instrument fee for percussionists, tubas, baritones, French-type horns, and bassoon players of $125 per year. Color guard, we have an equipment fee of $100. And symphonic band and wind ensemble members, we have a $25 concert uniform fee due by November 15th. Now, if you didn't make one of those bands in the first semester and make it in the spring semester, the fee will be due on February 15th.
All right, next we're going to talk about how to stay connected with our band. One of the primary means we use is by a software system called Charms. We're going to show you how to access that right now. You can go to a computer screen, that's right, and type in Charms Office.com. All right, and then enter there. And this is it right here, Charms Office Assistant. When you get to this screen, you look up here, it's under, it says Login up here in the corner. You can click on that. As it comes down, you get parent, student, members. That's going to be you guys. You're going to click on that. And then the school code will be Crestview HS Band, all one word. Enter that. Then it says enter parent area. All right, this is what the home screen will look like. Up here in this corner where it says student area password, your students will be given this at a later date. Right now, they do not need access to that, and it's not necessary to see the most important stuff on Charms at this time is going to be down here. The public calendar, you can click on that. Right now, there are not dates and times on there. There will be shortly. We're just waiting for our calendar to kind of settle. But over here, under handouts and files, that is the most important spot, so you can click on that. And then under here, you're going to see a bunch of stuff, everything you'd ever want to know. And in fact, we have a saying here in the band room, if you have a question about something, it's on Charms. So you can find it. Look on Charms and you will see it. But some of the most important stuff we want to point out to you guys. Right here is the Big Red Machine Handbook. You want to read that and make sure you familiarize yourself with what's in the handbook. Also, if you slide over here, you can see the BRM orientation slides. That's what would normally be covered in our in-person orientation meeting in May. However, this year, because for obvious reasons, we put it on some orientation slides for you guys. So please check that out. If you go on down, scrolling on down, you can see a whole bunch of scale sheets, everything you would possibly need. But right here is the remind codes. Right here, you can see remind 101, concert band, concert prep, percussion. Now, if you were at our band camp a few weeks ago, we went ahead and had the students sign up for these. But if you're not signed up, you need to make sure you click on your band and sign up for this so that we can communicate with you via text. All right. Anything else about Charms? All right, so those are some the ways we communicate are mainly through email, coming through your Charms email account. Also through Remind, we will send out text to you guys. And then one final way that we also reach out to you is through Facebook. There is a group called the Big Red Machine Band Boosters. If you go to that page and you request membership and you answer the questions, the membership questions, we can admit you into that group. If you don't answer the questions, we cannot admit you. So please do answer those membership questions. And so above all, stay connected. Thank you.
That concludes our orientation video. Thanks for watching. We are so excited to get to see you again, so do whatever you can do between now and then and beyond to stay safe. Wash your hands, wear your mask, whatever you can do so that we can be together again and stay together and have a wonderful year in the Big Red Machine. So until we see you again, we'll see you next time on Between Two Drums with Jody, Sean, and Kim. Crestview High School in the band program. As for me, I will also be working with percussion class. Did we finish yours?
We did, I'm done.
Okay, no, I'm done, you're waiting.
Oh, yeah. It's been a long quarantine.
You can wear the one that we give you. You can wear the one that you like the best. But we ask when we give you these that you keep up with them because they're gonna be our uniform masks. Time to go.
Well, it's been fun.
See ya. No, next period. So. I just want to leave it on this thing. Because if I go here, I'm going to see that. Right.